Having the proper skills for a job is important, but so is having the right tools. Applied Technology Foundation is working to supply one of those tools to individuals in our community and around the world. Dennis Lifferth, chairman of Applied Technology Foundation, is with us today to tell us more about their organization. Dennis, we appreciate you joining us today.
Russell, it's an honor to be with you today. Thank you.
So let's begin by talking about tools and that friend of yours that we've discussed before that needed tools.
So years ago, our family was assigned to work with a refugee family. We discovered that he was a very good mechanic, but didn't have any tools of the trade. So I had an extra set, I gave him the set of tools, and the next day I drove by his home, and already he was out working on a neighbor's car repairing that. So tools are very important. And it's like fishing. You can give a man a fish to help him out, or you can teach him how to fish, but you also have to help him have the tools, a fishing pole and a net, for him to be really successful.
And the tools of today, one of the major ones is computers, and that's kind of where your organization started from.
So a friend of mine, Randy Burgoyne, and I were talking about all the surplus computers that must be available in people's homes and closets and in businesses, and thought that's a tool that families ought to have. So we tested the water, checked with a few other corporations in town, and sure enough, they were willing to give these computers to people in need.
And I mean, it's helpful for the organization because not only do they give it to someone in need, but they can also find a way to dispose of their computers correctly.
It's a good way to take care of a used computer. You can't just throw them away. You have to recycle them properly. And so we do that. If we receive a computer that we can't refurbish, then we'll send it through another company that does recycle the computers.
And so you upgrade these computers.
We take the computer and clean them of all the data. We also upgrade the memory. We'll upgrade the operating system. And it turns out to be a very nice set for these people in need. Many people have never had access to a computer. The refugees come here without anything. And for them to have a computer is a great blessing to them.
What I think is incredible, though, is the cost is very small for your organization.
$25 pretty much covers the cost, and that's a great investment for some family.
And because the reward, I mean, you discussed some of these stories, the reward is great for that $25.
Well, I can give a lot of examples.
Why don't you give us one or two right now?
Okay. When the families come and they're greeted by Asian Association or Catholic Community Services, they receive the food and the clothing and shelter, but they don't receive a computer. And so we then meet with them and have them fill out a little form explaining their needs and their ability to use a computer. Then about 3 months later, after giving them the computer, we go back and check with them. So they have a very good record of the progress that they've made. One family that came from Burma had been in a refugee camp for 22 years, and they were desperate as they got here. The computer made it possible for their children to do better in school. He was able to find a job, and it just changed their life. They also used the computer to Skype with their family back home, so it was a real blessing to them. Another family came from Colombia, and likewise, he and his two children, his wife, didn't have a job, and the computer gave him a chance to get online, look for employment, learn to speak English, and take advantage of all the resources that are available.
And you were saying that, I mean, he has a great job now.
He has a good job.
He's able to get off the bottom rung there.
And furthermore, the children are able to do well in school. If you don't have a computer in school, it's very hard to do the assignments and to keep up with the other children. Fall further behind.
Let's talk about schools for a second, because there's a school you worked with in Idaho.
We did. Recently, we received a call from Salt Lake Chamber of Commerce. We'd worked with them earlier. They knew we were in this business, and they'd received a call from a school district in Idaho that was really struggling and needed computers. They gave us a call, and we just received a large shipment of computers from one of the companies here in town. So I called them. I said, we have these computers. We can refurbish them if you're interested. And they said, oh, we'd love that. So 2 weeks ago, we sent up 30 computers for the Butte School District to help their children.
Let's talk a little bit about the work that you do with the interns with the University of Utah and what services they're able to provide.
You know, really, the interns keep us going. They're the ones who do the work. And so we have volunteers and interns from University of Utah, LDS Business College, and other places in the Valley. They'll come in, they'll take the computers, process them, get them ready. They also will help train. So if a family doesn't know how to start a computer, how to get on the internet, they'll actually meet with them and help them get started.
And you'd mentioned before that the training is one of the great things that this organization is able to offer that these refugees or other needy individuals.
We're happy to do that for any time they'd like to come to the office and or have us go to their homes as well.
And now you and I talked to someone that was looking to donate a computer. And so what kind of computers are you looking for? And then maybe tell us where should we go to find out more information?
You know, we're grateful to receive any kind of computer. Laptops are kind of a high priority, or iPads. But desktops work as well. And once we receive them, then we'll determine if we can refurbish them or have to recycle them. So if they'll just donate them, we'll take care of that. It makes it possible for people to not have to worry about recycling, taking to the dump, which isn't proper anyway. And you can find out more about the organization by searching on the internet through appliedtechnologyfoundation.org or send an email to info@appletech.org.
That's good to know. Thank you so much for joining us today, Dennis.
Oh, it's been an honor being here. Thank you for this privilege.
To learn more about the Applied Technology Foundation, you can go to zionsdirect.com/charity. And to see other videos like this, subscribe to our Zions Direct YouTube channel.